Station. On its way.
faded gravity, melting away.
Thank you. Everybody's dreaming. happiness. trouble.
Of travel.
We'll be right back. Un maximum d'amour pour Boris Brejcha. Merci beaucoup, encore du bruit pour lui s'il vous plaît. Merci beaucoup aussi à vous qui étiez très chaud, à toutes les équipes techniques, FL Group, Cosmo AV, What's It, ETC, ATC pour cette lune incroyable. J'espère que vous avez apprécié. Et on se voit bientôt quelque part dans le monde. Bisous à tous. Et la prochaine fois, Boris à Paris au Trianon le 12 octobre.
How do you feel, man, after this set?
I don't know, man. I still remember like 2 years ago.
Yeah.
Chateau de
Fontainebleau.
Fontainebleau. And this was already amazing, but today, I don't know, it was fucking amazing.
Yeah. Totally. I'm so happy that you liked it. Because, as you said, Chateau de Fontainebleau, the bar was really high. I have personally really amazing souvenirs and memories from this set. I don't know if you have this.
Of course. So I mean, a lot of people are writing me because of this set. So, like, a lot of memories.
Amazing. So there are a lot of people asking questions on the online audience. Please don't hesitate to ask questions, and I will ask the best one.
Okay.
So please don't hesitate. Today we are celebrating the 50th anniversary of the first man on the moon.
I know.
I wanted to know, does the moon inspire you?
Actually, I have to say I was not thinking so much of the moon. I mean, we went there already, so I'm super looking forward for the Mars.
Mars, of course.
But I guess the moon is like, it's like the same kind of the sun for us. So in the daytime you have like the sun to give you like the energy and the power and the warm weather. And in the night you have, in the same case, like the moon, which is like super inspiring and sometimes, yeah, a little bit crazy in the same time. I like it.
You have a track called the Moon Dancer, right?
Yes. And I have a track to the moon and back.
Oh yeah,
so,
exactly.
So yeah, two tracks.
Two tracks. So I'm checking all the online questions.
Yeah.
Did you feel any difference or challenges compared to your first Cercle set?
Of course. I mean, the first set was like, I don't know, just look what we have there, and okay, the sound system is
not very good.
Not really good.
I remember.
Yeah, I remember. I mean, I was like two times saying no, I don't like to play there. So, but I mean, in the end, I'm happy that I did. So, but for tonight, I don't know. There's like, I was just coming here. I was like a little bit fucked up because the train was like delayed.
Oh yeah.
But in the end, like everything went well, and I was like super happy to play here, man. Super. The location is killer, man. Killer.
Thank you so much. Question from Steven: since you already reached the zenith of your career, what will you do next? What will be your next goal?
I mean, what can you do after the zenith? You know, if you reach this point. I think I'm not like 100% at the zenith because like last year I was playing Tomorrowland, but like not the main stage. So this year will be the main stage. So it's like getting a bit more up. But I think the best way you can do is like just produce music how you feel with your heart, and the people will understand. And I think the way is like going.
Yeah, and you also have your label, right?
Fucking Serious. Yeah.
It's going good.
It's going really good.
Yeah,
really good.
With new artists.
Yes,
we heard them tonight.
Yes, of course.
They Dream and Dennis Bull.
Yes, they're going really good.
Yeah. Great. I think I already...
One more.
Lautaro. What is the DJ of today that you admire the most and you like what he does?
It's easy. It's Stefan Botzin. Because like when I was like a little child, not even producing, there was already Stefan Botzin. So he was like kind of my biggest influence. And then I know the way of Botzin was like going a little bit down, but now it's like going to the fucking peak, man. Man, it's his killer, man. He's doing like killer stuff. I love it.
Awesome. And I have one last question. I saw on your Instagram stories that you produced a lot during this winter.
Yeah.
When will you release the new album?
The problem was we had like so many like contract problems.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we were doing like this contract for 2 years already.
Whoa.
So, but now we are set, and this year we have the first single. And then doing like month after month, one more single. And finally, in the end of this year, there's coming the album.
Oh.
I'm super happy because I have so many tracks, you know.
Awesome.
And the people are waiting.
Yeah, we are waiting.
Yeah.
Right. Well, thank you so much for this set, Boris.
Thank you.
I hope that maybe in 2 years, even better,
yeah.
Right?
Let's do that. Thank you.
And we have a little tradition. You know this tradition, it's a mystery box, a little gift.
Yeah.
That we will offer, and the Grand Palais, which is this amazing monument where you played tonight,
okay.
Will offer you this gift.
Okay.
Hi, Boris.
1 second. Hi.
So thanks a lot for this huge, amazing set that
you
gave under the magnificent nave of the Grand Palais. We were so delighted to welcome you here.
Yeah, no, it was...
As part of the Mood exhibition, you know?
Yes.
You heard about it.
I know,
yeah.
I know.
We had a big moon behind you, and we have an exhibition that will last until July 22nd, and which gathers with the relationship between the man and the moon since always. So Thank you again.
Oh, thank you. It was super fun.
Yeah, did you like it?
Yes, super fun. Super fun.
We have a gift, a mystery box.
Okay.
Which is here. And it's an engraving made by printers from... we have art workshops here at the RMN Grand Palais. And this engraving was made by a young French artist living in New York.
Okay.
Who's called Cyprien Gaillard. And his work is always questioning with humor the impact of man on nature. So here you have three historical engravings that he used.
Yeah.
And in which are confronted nature and urbanism. And the name of the work is Urban Revolution.
Revolution.
Urban Revolution. And so it's about, the relationship of men with nature and what's the history and the remains and the revolts of men and everything. So it's a very nice, at the same time, contemporary and historical work. And we are very delighted to offer that to you. And again, thank you very much for that incredible moment.
Thank you. Thank you.
I hope you enjoyed it.
Looks
as much
crazy.
As
looks really nice. Really nice.
Cyprien Gaillard. You know, you will, it's a very good artist. So thank you.
I'm going to keep it all my life.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Goodbye. Thank you.
Thank you very much, guys, for watching. Thank you to our partners. Thank you to the amazing mapping team, which has done this amazing work. I hope you enjoyed it. All the logos will come up on the screen. Thank you, of course, to Boris Brejcha, and we'll see you next week. Bye-bye, guys.